I would never go to a doctor that doesn't use artificial intelligence as a backup. You need to have the skills to use tools. Artificial intelligence is a tool. It's all it is. Would I trust AI to save my life? If you have a look at artificial intelligence, it's still quite at its infancy. But things are going to change very dramatically.
With AI, it can also make errors, like you said. But will there be ever a possibility of it being 100% automation?
I'm going to give a bit of a deep dive in there so you can understand that.
Hi, good morning, Werner. How are you today?
Good morning, Mohammed. Very good, thank you. Good to be in Malaysia.
Oh yeah, it's a beautiful country. I want to get straight to the point today that we will be discussing about AI in medical industry. As we know that now there's so many implementation of AI in the medical industry and has led to so much potential, like creating new drugs. And what do you think about this? Could AI, would you trust AI to save our lives?
Would I trust AI to save my life? That's a double-sided question. I'd say definitely yes and definitely no. I would trust a doctor that uses AI, that does his research properly. Because if you have a look at using artificial intelligence as a tool, and the doctor that uses the wrong tool, if he's going to do an operation on you, is going to fail as well. So the whole question is, what tool is the doctor using? What is he using the AI for? And does he 100% rely on the AI, or does he use a combination of AIs? If you have a look at artificial intelligence, it's still quite at its infancy. And I'm going to give a bit of a deep dive in there so you can understand that, because a lot of the artificial intelligence databases that are out there at the moment are still very elementary. So you have what you call the people that put AI together that go and name the parts of the body and what's going on in the body, because artificial intelligence has to learn. And when they name the parts of the body, sometimes it's not professionals doing that. So they might name the wrong artery, wrong name or something like that. So because of this elementary stage, you can have mistakes. So it's important to be able to have a doctor that uses AI but understands that you cannot fully rely on an artificial intelligence. Same, you cannot fully rely on a doctor.
I've heard a lot of people say that with AI, things can go 100% with automation, but with AI, it can also make errors, like you said. But will there be ever a possibility of it being 100% automation?
At this stage, no. Because if you have a look at artificial intelligence, if they have different benchmarks where they measure artificial intelligence. And if you have a look when LLMs came out in the beginning, like ChatGPT and Gemini, they were 40%, 50% on the benchmarks. Now they're getting at 80, 90%. So they've got to even start changing the benchmarks. Because it's the same, you cannot give the same benchmark for a 5-year-old kid and a 50-year-old man. Artificial intelligence has also been trained and getting better and better and better all the time, so the benchmarks changes. So answering your question over there, for at this stage at the moment, I would definitely not rely 100% on artificial intelligence. Subscribe to this channel if you're interested in what we're talking about. And please do ask questions in the comment section.
How does doctors or hospitals use AI?
Well, it depends what country you go to, and it depends the level of the hospital you go to, not only in the country. If you go to a hospital in Germany or in Belgium or whatever, the first thing they do at registration, you've got to sign, can you use my data or not? Because they're very conscious on privacy in Europe. So what happens? The people always say, I don't want you to use my data, it's private. Maybe this will get to my insurance company and they'll cancel my insurance because they see that I have a heart problem or I have a lung problem or whatever. So they have no data sets in Europe. That's a huge problem. So if you want to go and have a x-ray or a scanning on your heart, they have a very limited amount of data that they can compare with. In some countries, you're not allowed to use the tools. Some countries don't have the tools, but they have the data sets. So this is the great thing in a country like Malaysia, because we are a country that is neutral, just like Switzerland. We're completely neutral. We can deal with everybody. Like Switzerland's dealing with the Russians, they're dealing with the Chinese, they're dealing with the Iranians, they're dealing with Americans, with the Europeans, with everybody. And they're friends with everybody. They don't allow geopolitical situations make them choose their friends.
I think.
So what happens? They become one of the strongest when it comes to artificial intelligence and freedom and working with everybody.
Depending on the country, what's actually the main challenge? Is that people refusing to share their medical data or the country's AI policy?
Both. In Europe, for example, the people don't want to share their data because they feel it's too private.
Mm-hmm.
And in Europe, they've actually made so much regulation that the hospital cannot even send the data from Europe to here without getting permission from the government, let alone from the patient. I wouldn't trust a doctor without using artificial intelligence today. He must be kidding.
Yeah.
He gets up in the morning and he had a bad night with his wife or his girlfriend or he got drunk or whatever, and then he's got to give me what's wrong with me and have a 20 to 40% accuracy rate.
Actually, that could be quite troublesome in the future, because what if I'm from Europe and I had a heart problem and then I moved to a new country and I want to continue my medication and my checkups, and I won't be able to send my medical data to the new hospital or doctor in that new country. That would be troublesome.
Yes and no. It depends how you do it. Mm-hmm. Most people are not, I wouldn't say not educated, they're ignorant mm-hmm. on how to do that.
Yeah.
If you go to your hospital and you're in the UK and you said, I want all my data from my medical situation to be sent to Malaysia.
Mm.
The hospital say, well, you know, we first got to get permission from the government, we got to get permission from you, and then we will transfer the data.
Mm-hmm.
So it is possible, huge steps.
Yeah.
But if you tell them, give me my data, put it on, send it to me, or give it to me on a hard drive or on a chip or on whatever way you want to transfer it, and they give it to you, and you send it yourself privately, no one can stop you.
Yeah. Because it's in the end, it's your data.
Exactly. So you can make that decision. And but you do have some countries, if you're going to send medical things, you were supposed to ask permission from the government and so on.
Mm-hmm.
But things are going to change very dramatically there, because I would never go to a doctor that doesn't use artificial intelligence as a backup under no circumstances.
Yes.
And also the doctor needs to understand how to use it.
Mm-hmm.
Because the same, if you send a doctor to do an operation, say, okay, this guy needs a heart operation, you give him a screwdriver and the pliers, he's not going to succeed in your operation either.
Yeah.
He needs to know what tools are the best and how to use the tools.
Yeah.
And artificial intelligence is exactly the same.
Yeah. So in the end, AI can pretty much tell you that you're sick before your doctors do.
Absolutely. If you work with a professional doctor, they're not using LLMs. Some of them might be still using LLMs, but a professional doctor maybe has access to good databases and good data sets. A lot of the professional hospitals these days, they have their own synthetic databases where they keep all their data.
Mm-hmm.
Just like if you live in the UK, they cannot put your data online that everyone can pick it up. They have their own place where they keep their own files.
Mm.
So that's the issue.